Dear children, welcome back all of you to the physics online class, Royal Palace PU College, Jamkandi. And today we let us discuss about further things about the magnetism and the matter. In the previous session, we had a discussion over the properties of the magnetic field lines, right? And remember, dear children, that properties are very important for the point of examination also. That may be asked for 2 or 3 marks, right? Practice them. And also the diagram to draw the magnetic field lines around a bar magnet or a solenoid, that also may come for the 2 marks, right? Okay, then already all the points we had a discussion. Then today let us talk about what is the meaning of uniform magnetic field and non-uniform magnetic field. And next, in the first chapter we had a discussion about the electric field lines, and now in this chapter we are discussing about the magnetic field lines. Then definitely we should know what are the differences between these two field lines. Okay? Yes. First, let us learn about the uniform magnetic field and how it is represented. Then, what is the meaning of uniform magnetic field? Uniform. Uniform means same. So, the magnetic field which has the same magnitude and the direction of the field at every point, such a field we call as the uniform magnetic field. Is that clear, dear children? Right. What is uniform magnetic field? A magnetic field in which or at which the magnitude and the direction of the field is the same at every given point. So that we call as a uniform magnetic field. Then how to represent this? The magnetic field when it is a uniform is mainly drawn with the parallel lines separated with the equidistance when the direction is parallel to the paper of the given paper, right? So how it is represented? See here, uniform magnetic field whose direction is parallel to the plane of the paper is represented by the arrow marks which are separated with the equidistance. This is the representation of uniform magnetic field which is parallel to the plane of the paper. Then again, in a textbook you can see the another type of representation of uniform magnetic field, what that is, in this manner. Yes, you can see here the diagram. If like this diagram is shown in the textbook, means this is the representation of uniform magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of the paper in inward direction. That means assume there is a plane of the paper like this. Okay, if the magnetic field is perpendicular in this manner, which is in the inward direction, it is represented by this diagram, right? Then next one, if the magnetic field is, it is perpendicular to the plane of the paper but acting outward, how it is represented? Means it is represented with the dot lines. Sorry, dotted points. These dots, and you can observe here, all the dots are, they are separated with the equidistance. Okay, and see again, I repeat them. This is a magnetic field parallel to the plane of the paper. This is a magnetic field perpendicular to plane of paper acting inward, and this is magnetic field perpendicular to plane of the paper acting outward direction, right? So then what is the meaning of non-uniform magnetic field? Non-uniform magnetic field. Yes, non-uniform means different or irregular. Okay, so here all the field or the lines are represented with the equidistance. They have the same magnitude and direction. If slightly either the magnitude or the direction is changing, means what type of magnetic field it is? Non-uniform magnetic field. Okay, then how to represent that? See, the non-uniform magnetic field usually represented with the converging lines or the diverging lines or by the crowded or the spread out lines. That means you can see here, like this diagram is coming, means assume here is a one magnet end, like this diagram you can observe, means or else with the unequal distances between, the any two magnetic field lines, that gives the non-uniform magnetic field. I hope, dear children, you understood both the points, right? Yes. And let us move to the next point, that is differences. Differences between electric field lines and the second one, magnetic field lines. Yes. Whenever you are studying about the concept, we should be very clear what are the similarities and what are the differences what we are studying, right? And the first difference between the electric and magnetic field line is, electric field lines are the open curves. Remember, dear children, these are the open curves. Then what about the magnetic field lines? These are the continuous closed loops. These are the continuous closed loops. Very interesting, no? Yes. And the second one is, we have seen that in the case of electric field, the mono charge exists. Electric field line can be drawn for the mono charge. Mono charge means what? For the single charge. Yes, here mono charge exists. Mono charge exists. But remember, dear children, already I explained in the last video, that is, monopole does not exist in the case of the magnetic field or in the magnetism. Here, monopole does not exist. Yes, is that clear? Yes. Then the next difference is electric field lines start from the positive charge and ending at the negative charge, right? So they starts from positive charge and ends at negative charge. But what happens in the case of the magnetic field lines? Will they end there? No, they are not ending. they will start. That means they will so originate from the North Pole, terminate at the South Pole, even they are continuous inside the magnet. Remember this point, right? So they originate at North Pole and terminate at South Pole, even continuous inside the magnet. These are the three important differences between the electric field lines and the magnetic field lines. Yes, you should know that. So question may come, distinguish or differences, write the differences. Okay, then along with this, let us also discuss what are the similarities between the two field lines. Okay, now we got the differences. What is the difference between them? Now let us talk about similarities also. Similarities between the electric field and the magnetic field. First similarity, here also two electric field lines do not intersect each other, and in the magnetic field also two magnetic field lines do not intersect each other, same both the side. Yes, the second one, in the electric field line also they have a lateral repulsion. Laterally they are spreading, electric field lines are laterally spreaded out. Why? That shows us the like charges repel each other. Yes, the same thing happens in the magnetic field line also. There also there is a lateral repulsion that shows the like poles repel each other. Okay, then the next similarity is the longitudinal strain. That means electric field lines, when they are moving, they exert the longitudinal strain. That means they contract each other. That explains us two unlike charges will attract each other. Same thing in the magnetic field line also. It explains us the longitudinal strain between the magnetic field lines explains us the two unlike poles attract each other. Yes, I hope you understood the concept clearly. Okay, yes, let us moving to the next point, that is magnetic dipole. Right, what is the meaning of dipole? Di means two, pole means poles only. Yes, the magnet which has a two pole, that we call as a magnetic dipole. Then how to define that? It is very simple. Dipole or the magnetic dipole consists of two unlike poles of equal magnetic strength separated by a small distance. What is a magnetic dipole? It is a system of, or it consists of two unlike poles which offer same magnetic strength separated by a small distance. Then what are the examples for the magnetic dipole? What are the examples? The best example is a bar magnet. Yes, the commonly using magnet, that bar magnet, it acts as a dipole. Because you have seen at one end of the bar magnet is a north pole, another end is a south pole. Both the poles are separated with a small distance. And the second one, solenoid, that also act as a magnetic dipole. Next one, magnetic needle, yes, that also act as a magnetic dipole. Is that clear? Yes. Then next, let us talk about मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल मोमेंट, मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल मोमेंट। सी डियर स्टूडेंट्स, already you learnt the electric dipole moment, yes, and that was represented by p, small p. Then now talking about magnetic dipole moment, and this is represented by a letter capital M. Then definition, what is this? The magnetic dipole moment means it is the product of either of the magnetic strength of a pole and the separation between them. That means, assume here is the bar magnet, yes, and the north pole here, and this is a south pole. This is having a magnetic strength of M, and this is also magnetic because both the poles are unlike, but strength is the same only. Then the magnetic dipole moment is given by, it is the product of either of the strength of the pole and it is the separation between the two poles. Product of the magnetic strength of either of the pole and the separation between them. And see, dear children, you already know that M is a magnetic pole strength, yes. What is the SI unit of the magnetic pole strength? SI unit of magnetic pole strength is, what it is? Ampere meter. Remember, it is ampere meter. Then can you say me what is the SI unit of the magnetic dipole moment? Simple. See here. Magnetic pole strength has the ampere meter, right? And here you too neglect, it is an integer. L means it is the distance. Distance SI unit is meter. Then meter into meter multiplied is what? Meter square. That is why the magnetic dipole moment SI unit is what? Ampere meter square. And remember, this is a vector quantity because it has both magnitude and the direction. Hope you understood all the points what I explained today, right? If any queries, you can ask me, right? And thank you for watching the video, and keep in touch and do all the works given. Okay, thank you.